I'm Sebastian Davies, a learning experience expert at Dassault Systèmes. Hello, and welcome to this DraftSight for Beginners introduction video. In this multi-video series, we will develop an architectural drawing, starting with a basic deck that has a hatched area, annotation, and dimensions. So, let's get started. We start with DraftSight open, and two open drawings, shown in the title bar. This video, we use an existing drawing with some options already configured based on a metric template. If you choose to follow along with this video, you may see some aesthetic differences but still be successful in completing the task. The interface has distinct areas that we use in combination to achieve results. The workspaces define the available commands shown. In this video, we will use CAD General. The commands are accessible from the available ribbons or menus, while the command line lets us activate commands with keystrokes, displays command options, and provides feedback. To use DraftSight successfully, we will use a mixture of ribbon commands, keyboard input, and the mouse. We need to start the deck by indicating an outline. To do this, we will use the rectangle command and click a point to define the first corner. As soon as the command is active, options become available in the command line. Once we click the start point, these are updated. We know the deck size, so we will type D and press the Enter key to define the rectangle with dimensions. This prompts us to enter a horizontal value, so we will type 4500 and press Enter. We will then use the same method to set a vertical value of 2500, pressing Enter again to confirm the input and create the rectangle. We will now add dimensions to make the deck size easy to read when printed. We will use the Smart Dimension command on the Annotate ribbon to do this. Then we will click on the right vertical side of the rectangle, move our mouse, and click to place the dimension. With the command still active, we will click on the lower horizontal line and click to place the next dimension. Then end the command by pressing the escape key. We need to add a note identifying the deck, so we will use the note command, also located on the annotate ribbon. We'll click to indicate the first corner and type H to set a height of 150. The text type is significant, but we want it to stand out. Then we will click the opposite corner of the text note. The rectangle is placed and the note formatting bar is shown. First, we will type deck and then change the text justification to center from the toolbar. To complete the placement, we will click create note. The next step is to hatch the area to indicate the deck pattern. We can access the hatch command from the home ribbon. This displays the hatch creation ribbon, and we can change the settings here, but we prefer to type T and press Enter to access the hatch fill dialog. We will use the ellipses button beside the pattern to set a sample ARHBone style and click OK to confirm it. We will then specify the points for the hatch boundary. Moving our mouse inside the rectangle and clicking highlights the hatch area and shows us a preview. This looks good, so we will press Enter to return to the dialog. If the hatch scale does not look good, modify the scale option now. A smaller number equals a denser hatch pattern. Click OK to confirm and add the hatch. It's worth noting the hatch is reactive. We can see this by left-clicking on the text note and dragging it to a different position. In our next video, we will look more closely at the user interface and how to customize workspaces. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for even more great content and click the link in the description below to access additional tips, tricks, and training courses.